I'm Tony Wyss-Coray. I'm a neuroscientist here, and I'm interested in brain aging and neurodegeneration. And I'm going to ask you if you want to live forever, but let's get started first. So I'm interested in aging, and especially in how our brain ages and how it becomes susceptible to devastating diseases such as Parkinson's disease and Alzheimer's disease. So what is happening as we get older? Why do we age, and what is behind that? And this is really a tremendous problem, as many of you probably know someone who has Alzheimer's disease, maybe even in your close family or a circle of friends. And we really see a tsunami of Alzheimer's disease coming towards us. Just a few numbers, 32% of people at age 85 have Alzheimer's disease. And it's expected that just by the end of this decade, there will be 75 million people worldwide with this devastating disease. And this is a problem across the globe, because as we get older, more and more people are susceptible to these age-related diseases. And it's not just the aging brain that is, of course, a problem as you get older, but there are estimates that when you're 65 or so, you have on average two diseases that are clearly age-related. And as you get older, there's more and more diseases that affect people of age. So people in the aging community, in the science of aging, has started to contemplate with the idea that rather than tackling each of these diseases individually, so finding a drug for heart disease, finding a drug for Alzheimer's disease, for arthritis, diabetes, what if we could tackle aging? What if we could understand the basics, the fundamentals of aging, and target the aging process itself, and slow it down or even reverse it, what people often refer to as rejuvenation? And rejuvenation has, of course, been a dream of humanity since recorded history. There were always these ideas that there might be a magic water or a fountain of youth, as shown here in this famous painting by Lucas Cranach the Elder from the 16th century, where people who are old and frail enter this fountain and they emerge young and rejuvenated on the other side. So what I'm going to ask you now is, what would you do? I have two pills here. I have a red pill that keeps everything the way it is. And I have a green pill that gives you youth forever. So, which one are you choosing? The red pill? You stay, you're healthy, as I all see you, you're all healthy, you stay like this, you have your predicted lifespan, or you take a pill that gives you life forever. What, who wants to live forever and be youthful forever? Raise your hands. It's interesting. It's an interesting question. And of course, these pills are fake. but what if they weren't? It's a question that I ask young students that I teach. And we had lots of interesting discussion. Would you take it? Would you want to live long? Would you want to live 200 years? So let's not say forever, but 200 years. And what if that would actually become feasible? Now, it's unlikely that there will be a jump of 100 or 200 years. But what I'm going to tell you is that we actually have something like a green pill for mice. And so the field has made tremendous mind-boggling progress in finding interventions in mice. Now, mice are far away from humans. But in these models, interventions that target metabolism, such as caloric restriction, exercise, various small molecules, removal of cells that age in our tissues, they're called senescent cells, or reprogramming of cells in the body, where you try to make the cells younger again by removing some of the so-called epigenetic marks on the DNA, or treatment with young blood, with what we have been working on, and I'll tell you a little bit more about it, all these interventions make mice physically and molecularly younger. They slow down the aging process, and these mice actually often look younger than their siblings that are not treated. So we believe that we can intervene directly in the aging process in these organisms. And that has led to a flurry of publications with amazing discoveries, but also to investments that you may have seen, Altos Lab, with just tremendous amounts of funding, $3 billion in trying to tackle this problem and really target aging as almost as if it were a disease, to try to slow down and reverse then multiple age-related diseases. And Juan Carlos Espisua, who is one of the leading scientists in this field, has been quoted that within 2 decades we will be able to prevent aging. Now, I know Juan Carlos, I'm sure he did not say that, but that's how he was quoted. So it's real. There is really a rapid development in applying some of these technologies and showing that in complex organisms such as a mouse, you can have really impacts that slow down and reverse the aging process. Now, we have been focusing on one of the central tissues in our body, the blood, and there's of course the saying, young blood, rejuvenation with blood, and we asked the question, what if we would be able to rejuvenate the blood? So if we look at the blood, at the composition of blood in a young versus an old organism, we can actually show that there are dramatic changes. And here's just an illustration of that. So what we look at here are 3,000 different proteins in the blood of healthy individuals, age 20 to almost 100. And in the colors, we show in blue a low level of a protein, and in yellow, high levels of a protein. So you have 4,300 people that we line up here from left to right, and for each person we measure these 3,000 proteins. And you can see the dramatic changes that occur with aging. So young people have a completely different composition of the blood than old people. And that makes you wonder, and maybe understand, that if we change now the blood of an old person to a young one, maybe this will have an effect. And indeed, that's what we were able to find. Multiple other labs that if we use sort of a surgical paradigm where we connect two mice at their flanks such that they're able to exchange blood from young to old, or we actually give old mice repeated infusions of young blood, we can rejuvenate multiple organs such as the heart, muscle, liver, kidney, bone, pancreas, and aorta. And multiple labs have been able to reproduce these findings now. My lab has focused on the brain specifically, and here we were able to show that there are more stem cells in the brain that can make new nerve cells, new neurons. There is more chatter, there's more communication between the cells in the brain. There is less inflammation, and most importantly, these mice become smarter. So the old mice, they have the same problem that humans have. As we get older, we start to forget things. And we have behavior tests for mice where we can measure that. But if we give them young blood, they do better again in these tests. They function better. And we were able to translate this into humans. So in a number of clinical research studies that are still ongoing, first at the Alzheimer's Research Center here at Stanford, and then at a startup that I founded, and later by a large company that makes blood products, that collects plasma donations from many donors and then fractionates that. What these studies show that in early studies, multiple infusions of plasma from mostly young donors, on average 35 years of age, show sort of promising signs in small proof of concept and dosing studies. And excitingly, a large study that has actually more than 500 patients, the company Grifols removed first their old blood and then gave infusions of young plasma, or a fraction of plasma that is rich in albumin. And what they can show is significant benefits in disease progression, improving the memory in these individuals and also improving their daily functioning, suggesting that what we discover in the mice and what works in the mice might actually work in people as well. Of course, we want to understand how exactly does that work? What are the components in this blood that are able to do this and move this forward, hopefully into the clinic so that we can help people? And I just want to end with one additional note that we're really excited about. So if you imagine, as we're increasingly able to potentially slow down or target aging, we need to be able to measure it. We need to be able to tell a patient who comes in, how old are you, not in number of years, but biologically. We always often look at somebody and say, oh, you look much younger than you are. Right, so we can actually measure that at the molecular level. Remember I showed you these changes in the blood with age? If we take a sample of a person, we can pretty much tell you how old you are. But interestingly, we can tell you how old you are biologically. And so this is the concept of clocks that we're building, molecular clocks, where you have here in this comparison, you have the actual true age on the x-axis at the bottom from left to right, and then we calculate with machine learning based on all the measurements that we have done in large numbers of individuals, what your relative age is. And we don't do that just for the whole organism, but we actually do it for individual organs, for the muscle, liver, heart, kidney, and for the brain. So we can now measure in individuals how old is your brain. And what's super exciting about this, and this is our latest research really, is that if we look in individuals in our Alzheimer's research cohort, the top agers, so those we predict to having an older brain, we see out of 22 people who developed Alzheimer's disease, 18 of those were in the old brain group. And if we look at the ones who have younger brains, those 25% who clearly look like their brains don't age as fast, only 4 of those develop Alzheimer's disease. And more interestingly, if we collect a sample today and look 5 years later, who has declined in cognition? Who has sort of progressed and has lost their cognitive abilities? Those with young brains in the blue line tend to stay cognitively intact. And those who have older brains tend to decline more rapidly. So what we're trying to see is if we can use this in the design of clinical trials and hopefully in the application in the future of drugs that impact the aging process and can slow down and reverse aging. Thank you very much.